Good morning, students. In the previous class, we learned about the planets. Today, we are going to learn more about the motion of the Earth. Have you noticed the sun morning and evening? It is the same place throughout the day? No. That is seen east in the morning and west in the evening. We know the reason behind of it, the constant moving of the Earth around the sun. It seems the sun is moving, but it's not so. Sun is stable in position. Next is the shape and inclination of the Earth. What is the shape of an orange? Orange is spherical in shape. However, our living planet Earth is also spherical in shape. It rotates on its axis, which is an imaginary line that trends from the North Pole to the South Pole. Passing through the center of the Earth, the Earth axis always titrated or inclined from the vertical by an angle of 23 1/2 degrees. It makes an angle of 66 1/2 degrees with the plane of the Earth orbit. The Earth moves into two different ways. One is rotation, next is revolution. Now, rotation. It's the spinning movement of the Earth on its axis. The Earth rotates from the west to east, that is anticlockwise, and takes 23 hours 56 minutes and 4.09 seconds to complete one rotation. The time taken by the Earth to complete one rotation is called a day. The rotation of the Earth causes day and night. As the Earth is spherical in shape, only one half of it is illuminated by the sun at a time. The other half remains dark. The illuminated portion of the Earth experiences day, whereas the darkened part of the Earth experiences night. The line which divides the surface of the Earth into a lighted half and a dark half is called the terminator line. Next day we are going to talk about the revolution. It is the movement of the Earth around the Sun on its elliptical path, that is orbit its fixed path. The Earth takes 365 days, 1/4 days for it to complete one revolution. It revolves around the Sun at a speed of 30 km per second. For the sake of convenience, we take it has 365 days and call it a year. The remaining quarter day is added once in every 4 years in the month of February. That is why February has 29 days once in 4 years. It is called a leap year. The inclination of the Earth on its axis and its revolution around the Sun causes different seasons. Next topic is the sphere of the Earth. Earth is most suitable planet to support life. It has three major components that we are called as the realms of the Earth, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. The three components along with a suitable planet make life possible on Earth. All living things that existing narrow zone are called the biosphere. Now let us enter into the lesson. Close look up each of the sphere. First sphere is lithosphere. The word lithosphere is derived from the Greek word lithos, which means rocky. The lithosphere is the land on which we live life. It is the solid outer layer of the Earth, consisting of rocks and soils. Next is hydrosphere. The word hydro means water is Greek. The hydrosphere consists of water bodies such as oceans, seas, rivers, lakes, ice caps on mountains and water vapor in the atmosphere. Next, we will talk about the atmosphere. The word atmo means air in Greek. Atmosphere is the envelope of air that surrounds the earth. Different types of gases make up the atmosphere. The major gases are nitrogen 78% and oxygen 21%. The other gases like carbon dioxide, hydrogen, helium, argon and ozone are present in atmosphere. Next is biosphere. The narrow belt of interaction among the lithosphere, the hydrosphere and the atmosphere where life exists in known as biosphere. Bio means life in Greek. It consists of distant zone. Each zone has its own climate, plant and animals life. These zones are known as ecosystem. Next, we will move on to the glossary. That is meaning of the vocabulary. Galaxy means the cluster of stars. Second one, asteroids. Asteroids means irregular shaped rocks between Mars and Jupiter. Meteoroids, space particles left behind by comets or asteroids. Fourth one, comets. Comets means frozen lumps of rocks, dust and gas. Fifth one, satellites. Celestial bodies that move around the planets. Children, I hope you all understand this lesson happily. Thank you, student, watching this video. Have a nice day.